इस वीडियो में मैं इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स के वो सारे क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर रहा हूँ जो जेई मेंस 2019 में आए थे।
फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, ए प्लेन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी 50 मेगाहर्ट्ज ट्रेवल इन फ्री स्पेस अलोंग द पॉजिटिव एक्स डायरेक्शन एट ए पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट इन स्पेस एंड टाइम ई इक्वल टू 6.3 जे कैरेट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ वाई एक्सिस, दैट मीन्स वोल्ट पर मीटर। द कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बी एट दैट पॉइंट विल बी, that means we know two things, that E upon B is equal to C, also E cross B is equal to direction of propagation of wave, that is in this case this is I caret, so E is J caret, that is B equal to I caret, so B is equal to, according to cross product rule, I cross J, that is K, that means the direction of K. And the second thing, we can find E upon B equal to C, so B will be equal to E upon C, and E is given to in the question 6.3, and C is 3 into 10 raised power 8, so we are getting 2.1 into 10 raised power minus 8 K caret Tesla. Second question is, the magnetic field associated with a light wave is given at the origin by B is equal to B naught sine 3.14 into 10 raised to power 7 CT plus sine 6.28 into 10 raised to power 7 CT. If this light falls on a silver plate using wave function of 4.7 electron volt, what will be the maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron? Here two concepts are being used. One is the from EM waves and second is photoelectric effect. Here one more thing, that two waves are given of different frequencies, so naturally to find maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectron we have to take the maximum frequency. So here two frequencies are given, 3.14 into 10 to power 7 and 6.28 into 10 raised to power 7. So according to equation sine omega t, here omega that we will take 2.68 into 10 raised to power 7 C. Omega can be taken as 2 pi n, that is frequency. So n will be equal to 2 pi. And we know that E is equal to h nu. This is also nu. You can term it as n or nu. So this is nu. That means 6.28 into 10 raised to power 7 C. This is H, we should take this H. H into C is, agar hum isko multiply karenge, jo iski two values hain, 3 into 10 to power 8, 6 point, this comes, you must remember this quantity, this is 2 into 10 to the power minus 25. So 2 pi is cancelled with this, that means you are left with 2 into 10 raised to power minus 18. This is in joule. This is in joule, so we have to find in electron volt. Electron volt ke liye main isko 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19 se karunga. Upar 10 aayega, 20 by 1.6, that means this will be 12.5 electron volt. Now work function is given to you 4.7 electron volt. If work function is 4.7, that means the kinetic energy will be equal to 12.5 minus 4.7, that is you can say that 7.8 electron volt. Out of the options given, nearest is 7.72 electron volt. So answer is D. Answer is D. Let us do next question. The energy associated with electric field and magnetic field is given and you have to find the relation between these. So relation ke liye to hum lenge UE upon UB kar lete hain, aur UE jo hota hai, that is half epsilon naught E square, and magnetic energy is this is not that is maximum, we are taking the maximum. So after dividing this, we are getting epsilon naught mu naught E naught square by B naught square. And here what we will be taking, epsilon naught into mu naught, according to formula you know that this is 1 by C square and this is C square, this is equal to 1, so UE equal to UE. Next question, question number 4, if the magnetic field of a plane electromagnetic wave is given by B is equal to 100 into 10 to the power minus 6 sine 2 pi is given, then the maximum electric field, To find maximum electric field from B, we need to know maximum magnetic field. And maximum magnetic field, according to the equation here, 100 into that is equal to 10 raised to power minus 4. And what is, you have to find E naught, and E naught is equal to B naught into C, that is 10 raised to power minus 4 into 3 into 10 raised to power 8, that is 3 into 10 raised to power 4 volt per meter or Newton per coulomb. The same thing. Question number 5th. Let us find question number 5th. The electric field of a plane polarized electromagnetic wave in free space at time t equal to 0 is given by an expression this. In this question, E is given as 10j, j caret, cos 6x plus 8z. Now, this equation is given at t equal to 0. That's why here, in general equation, the t term is missing. Otherwise, equation at any time t should have been 6x plus 8z minus omega t. This part is similar to that is the standard equation of kx minus omega t. That means this shows the direction of or equation of progression of wave, electromagnetic wave. This is the direction of electric field, and this is E naught. If this is E naught for B, X, Z, T as it is asked, this will be 10 by C. We have to find the direction of magnetic field. This will remain same cos 6x plus 8z, since this is the equation of combined equation of electromagnetic wave due to this electric field and magnetic field. So this will remain same, but at any time t, the value of omega is to be find out. Omega is 2 pi by lambda into ct, from where we can find 2 pi by lambda. This is from here, that is 6i plus 8k and xi plus 8 plus zk, and this is equal to 2 pi by lambda. That means 2 pi by lambda equal to magnitude of this is 10. So here it will be 10 ct. Now the direction of electromagnetic wave will be unit vector of this vector quantity 6i plus 8k divided by 10. So we know to find the direction of any of these, that is the relation is E cross B equal to, that is a direction E caret dot B caret is equal to N caret, there is a direction of propagation of electromagnetic wave, or B, the direction of B can be find out, that is N caret cross E caret, that is equal to, I can find out I, J, K, N caret is 6 by 10, 6 by 10, 0, 8 by 10, and this is 0 in the direction of electric field, in the direction of J caret, that is 1, this is 0. So here we can find that this is I minus 8 by 10 as we calculate this plus K caret 6 by 10, 6 by 10, that is 6 by 10, so you are getting 1 by 10, 6 k caret minus 8 I caret. And if you put here, B will come out as xz t at any time t, that is 10 by c, 10 will be cancelled, that is 1 by c, 6 k caret minus 8 I caret, and cos 6x plus 8z minus 10 ct, and this option is A. Next question. An electromagnetic wave of intensity 50 watt per meter square enters in a medium of refractive index n without any loss. The ratio of the magnitudes of electric fields and ratio of magnitudes of magnetic field of the wave before and after entering into the medium. You have to find E naught by E and B naught by B. Now, this is the energy, this is the electric field before entering the field, this is electric field after entering the field, but there is no loss of energy. That means I can say that half epsilon naught E naught square is equal to half epsilon naught, not epsilon, epsilon and E square. Similarly, half B naught square upon mu naught is equal to half B square upon mu. From here I can find E naught square upon E square equal to epsilon upon epsilon naught. And from here B naught square upon B square is equal to mu naught upon mu. If I divide these two, mere ko जो मेरी रिक्वायर्ड रेशो है मेरे को मिल रही है, मैं इसको डिवाइड कर दूं अगर यहीं पे, क्योंकि मेरे को टाइम का भी ध्यान रखना है, E नॉट बाय E, B नॉट बाय B इज इक्वल टू एप्सिलॉन इनटू म्यू, ऊपर जाएगा म्यू इनटू एप्सिलॉन अपॉन म्यू नॉट इनटू एप्सिलॉन नॉट. इधर से मैंने स्क्वायर खत्म करना है तो मैंने रूट ले लिया, 1 बाय म्यू नॉट एप्सिलॉन नॉट इज C, 1 बाय दिस इज V, दैट इज N. And out of the options given, if I need this ratio as n, first option is root n by root n, root n by root n, that is equal to 1, ye nahi aata. Dusra aapke paas hai root n upon 1 by root n, this will be multiplied upward. So this B option is there, that is combination is root n and 1 by root n. Next question. Seventh question is, a 27 milliwatt laser beam has a cross-sectional area of 10 millimeter square. The magnitude of the maximum electric field in this electromagnetic wave. Here intensity can be find out. Here intensity is equal to I is equal to, this is 27 millivolt 10 raised power minus 3 divided by 10 millimeter square, 10 into 10 raised power minus 6. That is 27 into 10 raised to power, this is 2. So this is intensity. Intensity is milliwatt. This should be milliwatt, watt per meter square. So here this is intensity, and the relation of intensity is half C epsilon naught E square, E naught square. We have to find maximum electric field. So from here you can find maximum electric field, that is 2i upon C epsilon naught. By putting in the values 2 into 27 into 10 raised power 2 upon 3 into 10 raised power 8, 9 into 10 raised power minus 12. So here 9, 3, 27, this is cancelled, 2 into 10 raised to power, this will be minus 4 plus 2, 6. So E naught is equal to square root of 2 into 10 raised to power 3, that is 1.4 kilovolt per meter. This will be there. So next question. The mean intensity of radiation on the surface of sun is about 10 raised to power 8 meter, 8 watt per meter square. This is mean intensity. 10 raised power 8 watt per meter, RMS value aapko nikalni hai. As we have done, magnetic field, B RMS you have to find out. As we have done earlier, I is equal to half C B naught square upon mu naught square, upon mu naught. So from here, if I take this B naught square by 2, into C upon mu naught, this gives you B naught by root 2 gives you RMS value. So B RMS equal to mu naught I upon C under root. Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 raised to the power minus 7. I is given to you, that is 10 raised to power 8, and C is 3 into 10 raised to power 8. This is cancelled here. 3 is approximately cancelled with the pi. तो 4 इंटू 10 एस पर माइनस 7 आपको स्केयर रूट लेना है इसका. स्केयर रूट के लिए मेरे को ये इवन पावर चाहिए, तो मैंने इसमें कर दिया 40 इंटू 10 एस पर माइनस 8 अंडर रूट, दैट इज़ अप्रॉक्सीमेटली दिस इज 6.3 इंटू 10 एस पर माइनस 4. सो द क्लोजेस्ट वैल्यू इज 10 एस पर माइनस 4 टेस्ला. So this is all about the questions for electromagnetic waves. Those were appeared in JEE Mains 2019. Next topic will